Hi students, in this video we are going to see about the instruction pipelining and arithmetic pipelining in module 3. So in the last video we have discussed about the pipelining techniques and its introduction and its two types of pipelining technologies. In this video we are going to see about it the detailed type of pipelining technique, which is called as instruction pipelining. Instruction pipelining is one of the technique for implementing the instruction level parallelism within a single processor. Okay, so here ILP is one of the technology. It is one of the important concept where this instruction pipelining achieves the ILP within a single processor. And pipelining attempts to keep every part of your processors busy with some instructions by dividing incoming instructions into a series of sequential steps. Okay, so here the instructions are divided into some serial way of execution, serial way of execution. So where the entire part of your processor is divided into some incoming instructions into a series of sequential steps. We know the meaning of instruction execution phases. What are the four important instruction execution phases are available? One is fetch, second one is decode, third one is execute, and fourth one is write back. Right? Here we are going to see about the instruction pipelining processing, how it looks. So we know the meaning of instruction pipelining stages. Here in this example, this first diagram shows the 7-stage instruction pipelining. Right, here the execution stage of the pipelining takes 3 clock cycles for its execution. That's what it is called as 7-stage. So first stage is always a fetch stage, second stage is a decode stage, and third is a issue stage. Issue in the sense it is a one of the stage where it confirms whether the instruction is ready for execution. Okay, so whether the instruction is ready for execution is decided and declared in issue stage. Then after that ready state is decided and declared, it will enter into execution stage. For this kind of instruction execution, it takes 3 clock cycle and 3 stages for its completion. After the third stage of execution stage completion, it will enter into write back stage, that is the last stage of your pipelining, right? So this is what happening in the 7-stage instruction pipelining. Here in the middle diagram, some list of instructions have been given, and according with the list of instruction, how the pipelining stages are carried out also given here, right? So listen the second diagram, that is middle diagram. The first instruction is R1, that means memory of Y, and the location stored value which is stored in the Y while location is stored in is going to assign in R1 register. Is nothing but it is one of the registers which is available in processor. So the value which is stored in the Y location of the memory is going to be assigned in R1 register. This is the one instruction. How it is going to execute in the first pipelining stage means it starts from the first clock cycle as fetch stage, then it will enter into decode stage, then it will enter into issue stage. Issue stage is nothing but whether it in the issue stage only the instruction is confirmed, it's declared for its execution. So that means that it is ready for its execution. So at the fourth clock cycle to sixth clock cycle, the execution is carrying on, and that means it's performing its execution. At the seventh cycle, write back stages is carried out. Similarly, this parallelly, the second instruction also will start its execution at the second clock cycle. That means second clock cycle, the second instruction will start its execution. So how it will start means it will start with a fetch stage. So in the second clock cycle, the first instruction is in decode state and the second instruction in the fetch stage. In the third clock cycle, the first is in I stage, second instruction in D stage. And fourth clock cycle, first is in E stage, that means execution stage. Second one is in the I stage. Likewise, it will carry on. Coming to the third instruction, what is the type of instruction here? Means the value of R1 register and R2 register is added and it is going to be assigned and stored in the R3 register, right? So how it will start its execution? At the third clock cycle. Okay, as a third instruction, it will start its execution in the third clock cycle, because all instructions should be go on parallel. The first instruction will start its in the first clock cycle, second instruction will start its in second clock cycle, third instruction will start its execution in the third cycle. So what happens in the third clock cycle means first is instruction is in the I stage, second is in D stage, and third is in F stage. Then fourth instruction, second, likewise it will continue. So when you see the fourth clock cycle, first instruction is E stage, second instruction is I stage, and third instruction is decode. When this the third instruction is move on to the fifth clock cycle, what happens? Fifth clock, according to the fifth clock cycle, the third instruction should enter into the ith stage, that means in issue stage, but it can't enter, because why? Means what, you see the instruction, third instruction, it is an additional operation of the value stored in R1 register and R2 register, but at present R2 register is busy with the second instruction, because second instruction execution is going on in the 4, 5, 6th clock cycle. So at this time resource conflict occur, because the R2 register is busy with the second instruction. So what will happen? The time delay will be happen. Once the R2 register is relieved from its free from the second instruction, then only the third instruction will start its execution. Then only that third instruction will enter into its I stage. So that's what the black spaces, that black filled page spaces shows the delay in its operation, delay in its switch pipelining stages operation, right? So this is what happening in the seventh clock cycle. So this is the in order instruction issuing. Okay, how what is the order they are following? It is executed in a sequential way, but we can shuffle it based on our scenarios. So that reordering also is possible here. So that is what, in order to reduce the delays in pipelining stages execution, we can reorder the instruction execution. That is that is what shown in the third diagram. Here in the third diagram reduces the some delay, time delay in the pipelining stages execution, right? I hope you understand. Then move on to this arithmetic pipelining stages. Here arithmetic pipeline stages is most usually found in the maximum of the computers, because arithmetic instructions are the very very important thing. That means it talks about the scientific competition. Most of the computers will do some arithmetic operations only, right? That's what it is found in most of the computers. Then an arithmetic pipeline divides an arithmetic problem into various sub problems for execution in various pipeline segments. So what will happen means it will divide the entire arithmetic problem into some number of sub problems for the execution in various pipelining segments. Okay, and they are used for floating point operations, multiplication of fixed point operation. We know the meaning of flow arithmetic operation. Arithmetic operations are broadly classified into two types. For one is fixed point arithmetic, another one is floating point arithmetic, right? Here fixed point arithmetics are common. What are the basic operations? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and divisions are the common fixed point operations, but floating point operations are somewhat advanced. So how that, for executing the floating point arithmetic operation, we need to follow some formats. How it is formed means we know the meaning of general format of floating point. So it will starts with the sign symbol, sign in the sense positive or negative, then exponent e. E is the next format of floating. Then third one will be the mantissa, that is M. We know the meaning of exponent and mantissa, right? So if you take 32-bit representation of floating point number, means the first bit, that means 0th bit is always sign bit, and 31st bit, that means it will start from the 9th bit to 31st bit carrying the value of mantissa. From 1st bit to 8 bits, it carries the values of exponent. Like that, this as format is made, right? Here it shows the how n bit carry propagate adder CPA. CPI is nothing but carry propagate adder, which allows either carry propagation or applies the carry look ahead techniques. So carry look ahead technique is there, carry propagation adder is there. Here carry save adder is also there. These are all you have studied in the computer organization subjects in the last semesters, right? So this is what happening in this arithmetic pipelining stages, right? So this diagram shows the carry propagate adder and carry save adder, right? I hope you understand this logic. I'll catch you in the next video about next topic. Thank you.